Hello and welcome to Organic Edible Garden. This week we're going to look at making hoops for our veggie beds. We intend on planting our brassicas in a couple of weeks' time and we want to protect them from the white butterfly. Hoops aren't only for this time of year. We use them all year round in the garden. At this time of year, we're using them to protect our crops from things like birds and butterflies. And during the winter, we cover them with thicker mesh like a microclimber or a plastic, and this warms up the soil for our cold times. You can make hoops from just about any material, but what I like to do is I use 6mm steel. You can get this, it's a reinforcing rod from any concreting place or steel merchant. They're reasonably priced at about $2.50. They last for years in the garden and we cover it with some old hose just to give it protection. You can make your hoops any size, but for me, I use a 3 metre piece of steel. The reasons I do this is because my beds are just over 1 metre wide and I need at least 50 centimetres either side to push into the soil. So that still gives me 2 metres of a hoop. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to make a loop about 50 centimetres in from the end of the rod. And we're going to do that for 3 reasons. Firstly, when pushing the hoop into the ground, it's good to stand on something to push it in. Secondly, we can tie string through the loop. And at the end, when we're putting the netting over, we can peg that netting to the string. And thirdly, it's going to keep the piece of hosing that we're going to cover the rod on secure. The next thing, it's important to put the hose on at this point. Before doing our second hoop, we're going to turn it so this faces outwards, and that way both our loops will be on the same side. If you find the steel quite difficult to bend, using another bit of pipe does help with the leverage. If they're not connected, it's good just to get a heavy hammer and give them a belt to put them back into shape. When using the pipe, it makes the hoop tighter, but often they don't join together, so often hitting it with a hammer and putting them together is the best way. What we're going to do now is bend our hoops, and I find an old fertilizer barrel like this is great for that. And always making sure that your loops at the end of your pipe are always flat when you're putting it around the barrel. And then we can put them in the bed. And because they're steel, they're adjustable, so you can spread them out or push them in depending on your size of the bed. We'd probably place them about 1 metre apart throughout the whole bed before we cover them. We're using hoops in a raised bed like this and covering with a soft mesh. This mesh is great to use during the summertime when you want to keep things like your butterflies and your birds and even cats out the garden. In this case, chickens roam around this area and love to scratch up new dirt, so I've covered them with the hoops to keep them out. In this bed, we're doing a trial of different types of peppers, from really, really hot to mild. The same with the flowers. We're trialling different types of dwarf flowers that will take neglect and no water over the summer months. But as the weather gets a bit colder, we'd use something like a plastic, or even better, a microclimber. This is a knitted type of cloth, and what it does, it lets the water through and the air through, but it increases the soil temperature of up to 4%, and it helps your crops grow better over winter. These plants are of the Scarlet Runner seeds we planted 2 weeks ago, and they've come up great. Now is the time that they're going to want lots of water. Beans, more than any other plant during this period, want tons of water, and that's the way they stay nice and crisp. Unwatered beans often end up being stringy and hard. And even our dwarf bolotti beans have come up really well. You may think they're planted close together, but because they're dwarf, they're going to be self-supporting. All I need now is a really good watering as well.